I'm going to use this 1,000-gallon tank for my fish. The tank is 5 feet tall, and I'm a bit worried that kids may try to climb up to see the fish and fall in. I bought a couple of windows for it from the aquaponics source, and this is how I installed them. I decided to vertically center the window in the tank. Measuring down from the rim of the tank, I set the top and marked where the first drill hole should be. The first hole to be drilled should be one of the top center holes in the window. Entering the point of no return, I drilled the hole through the tank's wall. It was quite unnerving drilling a hole through such an expensive tank. Using one of the kit's bolts, I temporarily hung the window to the exterior of the tank. Using the bolt as a pivot point, it makes it easy to level the window and mark the center hole along the bottom. I then drill out the second hole. Not included with the window kit, I found a long bolt. From the inside of the tank, I put the bolt through the original hole in the top center of the window and through the tank. This bolt is used to temporarily hold the window in place and allows me to force the window to roughly match the curvature of the tank. I also add a bolt through the bottom hole and lightly tighten the nuts on them. Now that the window is bolted in place, I can drill additional holes next to the original anchoring bolts. The window will act as its own template in the event there are any slight variations in the pre-drilled holes in the window. After the adjacent bolts are inserted, the washers and nuts can be added and lightly tightened. I continued to work my way from the center to the outer edges. The outer edge holes can be drilled at the same time, since the window is now completely pulled against the tank. Now that I know exactly where all the bolts are located, I can mark where the cuts can be for the window opening. I used my level since it's 1 inch thick, and marked lines along the bolts. At each corner, I draw a small curve using a scrap piece of 2-inch pipe. The curved corner will help to prevent a tear in the tank once the pressure is against it. It's time to remove the window template. Just remove all the nuts and push the bolts through. Then remove the long anchor bolts. To cut the window opening, I first started by drilling a hole for the saw blade and used a saber saw with a new sharp blade. If the blade gets too warm, it will start to drag and melt the plastic instead of cutting it. It's best to stop, let the blade cool, and replace it if necessary. After the cutting is complete, all the burrs need to be removed with a file, and then sanded smooth. Also, any burrs around the drill hole should be removed. The surface of the tank should be completely clean before mounting the window. I cleaned it with water, dried it, cleaned it with acetone, and let it dry again. Just check to make sure the plastic doesn't react with acetone before using it. I put a bead of silicone on either side of the bolt holes. The silicone doesn't bond with the HDPE tank and will bond poorly with the Lexan window, so it's not used as an adhesive. Its purpose is to act as a gasket between the tank and the window to prevent the water from leaking out. As long as the window still has its protective coating, it doesn't need to be cleaned. The window is mounted the same way it was when I used it as a template by holding it in place with the long anchor bolts. With the long bolts, you can see how easy it is to pull the window to match the tank. When the nut is tightened down, the silicone bead flattens out in both directions, and any air that would be trapped between the beads escapes through the drill holes. Underneath the head of each bolt, I put a dab of silicone to prevent the water from leaking through each bolt. Any of the silicone that oozed out of the joint, I just smoothed it out. It doesn't help with the seal, but does clean up the area a bit. On the bolt heads, I spread the silicone around to make sure there was enough silicone to cover the polycarbonate and bolt head area. I let the silicone cure for about a week, and the tank is ready for water. So far, no leaks. Thanks for watching!